Invasive breast cancer. What is invasive breast cancer? Well, cancer start off inside the ductal system, and that's called in situ. Then the cancer grows through the walls of the ducts. Think of the ducts as being like small straws inside your breast, and that they branch. So once the cancer grows through the walls of the ducts, this is now called invasive. In other words, it's invading outside the confines of the ductal system itself. Now, we've known for over 30 years that once a cancer becomes invasive, then the opportunity to shed off cancer cells is now present. An analogy that I use for this is thinking about opening the door of a room and throwing grass seed out the door. And as you shed cancer cells, they can circulate elsewhere in your body. They can potentially set up shop in places that are not desirable, such as lung and bone and brain and liver and places like that. So that's the whole reason. This is really important now. That's the whole reason why we've known for many years now that in addition to whatever kind of surgery we do, in addition to whatever kind of radiation therapy we may do, that we have to treat the whole body. And I'll explain more about the treatment of the whole body in other videos, but in essence, the treatment of the whole body may involve anti-hormonal therapy if you are estrogen or progesterone receptor positive, and of course it may involve chemotherapy as well. So the bottom line of an invasive breast cancer is not only do we have to do the local control in the breast and the lymph nodes, but we must also treat the whole body. Hi, I'm Dr. Jay Harness, and I want to share with you important information that I believe that every newly diagnosed patient with breast cancer needs to know.
I'm a breast cancer survivor.
I am a breast cancer survivor.
I am a breast cancer survivor.
And I want every woman to know
about personalized breast cancer treatment
and the genomic test.
A test that helps guide a woman and her doctor
to the best treatment options for her.
Pass it on.